What I want to ask you is, I want to play devil's advocate here because, on one hand, I do understand the need to take what you're saying to a national stage. But on the other hand, certainly in my lifetime, this is probably the best crop of presidential candidates because we have a number of really progressive people running who I support and admire, you know, Bernie Sanders, Tulsi Gabbard, Elizabeth Warren. So let me ask you this. What do you say if somebody says, well, Mike, I see what you're doing, but you're just taking time away from the candidates who actually want to be president? How do you respond to that objection?
Very simply, because I have a better concept of what needs to be done. Here, Tulsi Gabbard and Bernie, and to some degree Warren, I endorse wholeheartedly. I donated to Bernie last election, and I think that Tulsi has the finest gravitas and the delivery of intellectual ideas of anybody I've ever heard of. But now, what is it that I bring to the table? I'm not sucking up their oxygen, because obviously, I won't win any more than 20 some odd others won't win. They're not going anywhere. But what's important is, let's say Bernie's got an agenda. Let me ask you a question. Do you think he's going to get his agenda enacted if the Democrats don't get a hold of the Senate? What's going to happen to his agenda?
Yeah, it's not gonna go anywhere. Absolutely.
That's right. So even if they got the Senate, when the last time the Democrats controlled the House and the Senate was when they passed Obamacare. At the time that it came out of the committee, 70% of the Americans wanted the public option. They never put it there. They made the judgment that, well, oh, we don't think we can sell that. That's crap. If you don't reach out, you'll never get it. And so what I'm advocating is that we elect the progressives, the most progressives to office, which would be Bernie and Tulsi in my mind, and then we equip them with the ability to get their agenda enacted into law. It's not going to be the Congress. It's going to have to be the American people who are going to be able to make laws. So if you ask the American people, are you for single-payer health care? They'll win overwhelmingly. Are you for doing away with the well, let me get some issues out that I would continue. Do you want to repeal the Electoral College? You think that would pass by the people? And of course, that would benefit cleaning up elections. I want term limits for all federal judges. So if we got a bunch of bad judges on the Supreme Court, the sooner we can term limit them, the sooner we can clean that up. And then you can go on to other issues like the right. It should be in the Constitution, the right to health care, the right to education, the right to economic security. These should be in the Constitution of the United States. I've got a process to bring this about. And all it is, it's a constitutional amendment and a Legislative Procedures Act that is enacted by the people. The Congress will never enact this. The elites who control our society will fight this tooth and nail. But with the constitutional amendment that I have designed, we don't have to worry about them.